I thank the kind introduction and also the opportunity given by Germán Moya and my colleague Antonio Ferreira, who invited me for this presentation. I would like to say good morning for colleagues in Central America, good afternoon for my colleagues in Brazil, good evening for my colleagues in Germany, Italy, I don't know, in England, who are also attending this presentation. I will tell a little about the history of this project named Maglev Cobra. Let's start with some considerations about our world nowadays. As you know, the slide is not, but as you know, we are now approximately 8 billion people living on the world. And from these 8 billion people, more than 50% live in cities. And if you look at countries like in Latin America, in North America, this share is greater than 80%. The suffering, the pain lives in our daily activities in cities. And now we had a surprise with COVID. And COVID showed us that we can organize meetings, we can make business through the internet, as we are now profiting for this possibility. Also, with the COVID, we increased our shopping through the internet. And also, we learned that it's possible to do a good homework, perhaps better than sometimes when we go to the office. It's a time for reflection. It's a new time for reflection. And I have discussed this subject with many colleagues. And in our opinion, you can comment it at the end of my presentation. But our point of view is that after COVID, special attention must be given to urban mobility. Urban, not interurban, not international mobility, but urban mobility. Because we need it to build, to repair, to take care, to meet, to dance, and also to the logistic of cargo transportation. In this case, we are speaking not just about urban, but also interurban and international. All these ideas are behind what we call smart city. In fact, smart city is one of the goals of the United Nations. And when we speak about smart cities, we speak about smart mobility. And today, our focus will be public transportation. And for public transportation, we know some solutions. These are pictures from my city, Rio de Janeiro. And this one, a monorail from São Paulo. But I ask, are these really solutions for our mobility? For instance, the segregated bus line, the BRT, we need to change these buses by buses, electrical buses or hydrogen buses. The subway, we can call it a urban mobility, but sometimes it's not human. 12 people in one square meter. This is not fair. And the monorail, when it stops in the middle of the line, we need to call the firemen to rescue people. And the light heavy vehicle, has a lot of accidents. It's also dangerous for pedestrians. And then you wonder, do you have a solution for that? A solution without such problems? And my answer is yes, I have a solution. The name of the solution is Maglev Cobra. And it's about Maglev Cobra that I'm going to speak today. And I organized my presentation with the following outline. I will start speaking about magnetic forces that can be used for levitation. Then came the name Maglev. After that, we will discuss. The presentation is not flowing. About the historic positioning of Maglev technology. Then we'll speak about the geographic positioning of Maglev technology. After that, I will go in details about the Maglev Cobra project. And we will compare it with the solution with wheels and with other Maglev technologies. Then you will be able to understand the name, the new name, Maglev Squared Cobra. We will show that there are many unfolding opportunities with this technology and show our future steps and finally the conclusion. Let's start with the magnetic forces that can be used for transportation. You will see that there are two methods that everyone already knows, are method one and method two. We all know that a magnet has a force, attraction force to an iron piece. And also we know that two magnets with the same polarity have a repulsion force. We can use these attraction and repulsion forces to make a levitating vehicle. But by playing with magnets, we know that these are unstable conditions. Nevertheless, by the middle of last century, there was enough technology that allowed to turn these forces, to use these forces to make something useful. But what's more interesting, what is awesome, is that at the turn of the century, new magnetic materials and new superconductors allowed a third type of levitation that we call superconducting magnetic levitation, and that is stable. This is the main difference between this levitation method and the others. I would also like to call your attention about the name of these methods. Very important here that we will mention in the future, the electromagnetic levitation method based on attraction forces. Okay, let's show a small video with the levitation method that we use in Maglev Cobra. This line here is made of magnets, are all the same magnets. And inside these boxes, we have at the bottom superconductors. Superconductors must be refrigerated to have the property that allows this levitation. You see what's wonderful, my colleague is trying to pull that box, and it's not so easy to do it. The boxes are, in fact, thermal boxes. Inside of these thermal boxes, we use liquid nitrogen. These boxes are so important that they have a name, a special name, cryostat. The movement along the line is possible because all magnets here are the same. It's like that the superconductors at the bottom of these cryostats do not recognize that they are changing place. Now here, you see, it recognizes that there is no magnet and it stops. It's awesome. This is the method that you use in our training. Let's make a short review of the history of maglev technology. You know that in the middle of last century, the transistor was invented, and 10 years later, the thyristor. The transistor started what we call microelectronics, the thyristor, what we call power electronics. With these two new materials, it was possible to implement the levitation methods based on attraction and repulsion forces. It was possible to organize the system to work in a stable form. We had to wait 40 years to have new materials, new magnets based on rare earth materials and new superconductors refrigerated with liquid nitrogen. And just then, it was possible to implement the methods that we are using in maglev cobalt. You see, this is a great opportunity for innovation because our new materials that we are using. We can also understand the history of maglev technology about the conferences that are organized to discuss this subject. The first one was in 1977. I point out here the conference in 2000 was the first time that the conference was held in South Hemisphere in Rio de Janeiro. And at that occasion, we started our project. 14 years later, we hosted again the maglev conference. And at that occasion, we inaugurated our maglev cobra prototype. About the geographic position, I will just point out the maglev that are in commercial operation and divided in high speed maglev in yellow and urban maglev in red. When I speak about high speed maglev, I'm speaking about 450 kilometers per hour or higher. When I speak about urban maglev, I'm speaking about 70 kilometers per hour or 100 kilometers per hour. There is in commercial operation just one high speed maglev in Shanghai, a German technology named Transrapid. And urban maglev, there is one in Nagoya, Japan, one in Seoul, South Korea, and two in China, one in Beijing and the other in Changsha. The technology that we are working that based on superconductors and permanent magnets, there are three main projects. One in Chengdu, another in German, and our maglev cobra. There are other groups also doing research on these subjects, but the prototype that they have are small scale one. I know, for instance, projects in Portugal, Italy, and Russia. Let's show some pictures about these projects using the superconducting magnetic levitation method. I must express that they are not in commercial use. This on the left side is the project in China, in Chengdu, is a line inside the laboratory, 45 meters long. The vehicle is for one passenger. In German, there is a project also inside the laboratory, is a line, closed loop line, 80 meters for two passengers. This project from Dresden is now moved to Karlsruhe, where they have a research center on superconductors. And the Chinese have already improved the vehicle, and now they can carry four passengers. Our maglev cobra project can be summarized with this graphical abstract. We have two rails of permanent magnets, one on the left, one on the right side. These magnets are the same that I have shown in our video at the beginning of the presentation. And instead of normal wheels, we have the cryostats with superconductors at the bottom and refrigerated with liquid nitrogen. As I told, these boxes are thermal bottles, and the liquid nitrogen can stay here inside during one day. And for the traction, we use a linear motor in the middle. Each cryostat can support a weight of 200 kilograms. It's incredible. Our line is 200 meters long, is outside the laboratory, and we can carry 20 passengers. This is a bird's eye view of our elevated line at the university. This is the announcement of the Maglev conference on the last day of the conference, on the 1st of October 2014, we inaugurated the line. These are pictures of that day. And 1 year later, in October 2015, we started to have visitors every Tuesday, was open to visitors. And until COVID, when we had to stop the presentations, we had more than 20,000 visitors. This shows with pictures the history of our work. We started with a small scale prototype during 2000 and 2006. Then with support of the government of the state of Rio de Janeiro, we made the construction of a full-scale prototype inside the laboratory, the same situation that they have now in China and Germany. And finally, we could make the construction of our outside line. This can be summarized as proof of concept, laboratory prototype, outdoor prototype, and now we are working to make the construction of our first product. To better understand this development, we can use a method established by NASA, is a scale that they call technology readiness levels. There are three levels that are basically a small scale proof of concept. Then they have two levels that are basically a full scale laboratory environment. This here is where German and China is, and the other projects using the technology, superconducting magnetic levitation, are in this blue level. And then there are two levels in red that are basically the full-scale external environment, is where we are. And NASA has also two steps. They call that mission qualified and mission proven. That in fact is a first product. But NASA is happy if they have two or three or four pieces of equipment, and they stop here. We want to industrialize. Therefore, we need a level, a 10th level, level 10. But this doesn't belong to the proposal of NASA, at least nowadays. It's my proposal. TRL-10 is where I want to go. And we can also better understand this scale, look in a ladder, and each step is more difficult to go than the later one. We are exactly here at level 7, trying to go to level 8. Again, the same pictures with the ski. And now, with a much better English, I have a small film explaining everything that I have spoken until now. Let's listen to it in just 2 minutes, and I hope you will enjoy it.
This 200-meter experimental line might seem short, enough to show the world's most modern technology when it comes to superconducting magnetic levitation trains. It is Brazilian. The first working prototype of the Maglev Cobra train is now open to the public, connecting 2 buildings in this Federal University campus.
I'm very happy to see how the project went from being studied in the classroom to being put into practice. And now we can ride it.
Just take a very close look and you will see the train runs 1 centimeter above the ground. Instead of wheels, it has superconductors that repel the magnetic rails, so it floats in the air. China and Germany are developing similar projects, but the Brazilian technology is the most advanced, says the project coordinator.
The main difference between our project and the projects in Germany and China is that we are already outside the laboratory, not inside.
The train is powered by electricity and designed especially for high-density urban centers. The testing speed is about 12 kilometers an hour, but it will be able to reach speeds of 100 kilometers an hour in urban areas.
This prototype is the result of more than 50 years of research. The train has several advantages. It is non-polluting, it's silent, and stable, and except to test it on longer tracks.
The tests will continue until the prototype is certified. Then it will be ready to move into production. It will take some time, but experts say this is the future of train travel. Lucrecia Franco, CGTN, Rio de Janeiro.
I like very much this work of CGTN. In my opinion, it's the best description of the project. Let's now compare the Maglev Cobra with the technology that you use wheels and rails and other Maglev projects. We will make the comparison considering construction and operation costs. For instance, the cost of the levitating material is much higher than the cost that we have to buy wheels and rails. This is not a problem of our technology. This is for all Maglev technologies. But when you look at the cost and time of the civil construction, Maglev technology has some advantages and easy to understand it because with Maglev technology, the force, the weight of the vehicle, is not concentrated on the point of contact of the wheel and the rail. The load is distributed along the line. Moreover, we can go up and down with higher inclinations, and this avoids the construction of tunnels and bridges, which makes the civil engineering construction very expensive and also take a lot of time. Now, considering the operation and maintenance, the acceleration and braking time of Maglev technology is better than with wheel and rail. Again, because now the acceleration and braking time is given by a linear motor. We do not depend on the friction between wheel and rail. The costs on maintenance and fuel are lower. Also, again, because we do not have mechanical contact. And the impact on audible noise and CO2 emission is lower. Then, in many cases, these advantages compensate for the disadvantages of a higher cost to levitate. With now, we can also compare costs, because these solutions were implemented in Brazil in two or three years ago. I know the prices. For instance, the segregated bus line, the cost was $6 million per kilometer. The monorail in São Paulo, $12 million per kilometer. The subway, $60 million per kilometer, because in this case, we have to dig tunnels in a populated area. This is extremely expensive. In the light rail vehicle, the cost was $8 million per kilometer. In our estimation, the Maglev Cobra will also cost around $8 million per kilometer. We have to, yes, thank you. Okay, let's now compare the technology that is used in the Maglev system operating commercially, the electromagnetic levitation method that based on attraction forces with our Maglev Cobra. You see, to have the levitation using electromagnetic method, you need a lot of iron, you need copper, you need windings, sensors, actuators, backup batteries. It's really sea and huge. With the Maglev technology, we basically use that cryostats, the thermal boxes with superconductors inside, in the rail of magnets. Our case is stable and simpler. Now, if we compare the elevated lines, these are pictures of the Maglev operating in Nagoya, Japan, that one operating in Changsha, China, and the third one in Seoul, Korea. When we compare these elevated bridges with our elevated bridge, we see that our solution is slimmer. This is because our vehicle is lighter than the vehicle, the other Maglev solutions. And what's more interesting is the railroad switch. On the left side, you have the Maglev train in South Korea. You see, the train embraces the beam. If you want to move from this direction to the other direction, the beam must move. And this is the traditional solution of railroad switch. In this case, just the rail moves. In this case, we need to move the beam. I have a short video to show how incredible is this solution. Pay attention. Please, this beam will move from one direction to the other. The solution that we propose for the Maglev Cobra is very simple. We have here in black permanent magnets and in red electromagnets, exactly on the place that we want to switch from one direction to the other direction. We have just to change the supply of energy from one direction to the other direction. This will be done without mechanical movement. This will be done very quickly. And now we can understand the name Maglev Squared Cobra. And for that, I organized a table with words in English, in Portuguese, in Latin, in an abbreviation. Let's start. Magnetic, magnético in Portuguese, in Latin, magneticus, abbreviation mag. Levitation in English, levitação in Portuguese, levitatio in Latin, abbreviation lev. Light in English, leve in Portuguese, leves in Latin, abbreviation LEV. Then you see MAG LEV squared. And now COBRA. COBRA in English is this snake, is Naja snake. In Portuguese is COBRA Naja. And from there, COBRA. The name Maglev squared COBRA. That shows that there is a new Maglev. It's not the same Maglev that we already know. But this is not just a project for transportation. There are a lot of unfolding opportunities. For instance, the production of rare earth magnets that has a lot of applications. I'm just pointing here in electrical motors. The production of superconductors, that there is no doubt that they will impact the electric sector in this center. The production of power electronics converters, linear motors that have many applications, industrial applications, and the production of light ray vehicles. And I must mention magnetic bearings. In fact, it's the same technology, but just used for rotation. With magnetic bearings, we do not have friction, and we can reach velocities of 90,000 rotations per minute or higher. This is a small drawing of a magnetic bearing. The axis is fluctuates without ball bearings, without contact, supported by magnetic forces that are given by radial bearings and axial bearings. In fact, we will host the International Symposium on Magnetic Bearing. This will be the first time that this conference will be held in South Hemisphere. And the first edition was in 1988, and it occurs each 2 years. It should be this week, but due to COVID, we had to postpone it to next year. You'll have enough time to visit us. You can go to our website and see the information about this conference. The logo gives the idea of a rotor supported by magnetic forces. But since this will be the first time in South Hemisphere, we organized it with the South at the upper part and the North at the bottom. It will be a pleasure to meet you here in Rio de Janeiro. And how are our future steps? What is in your mind? You know, the university where I work is an island. And I have a dream. Sometimes I believe it's a nightmare, but it's to turn the university campus in a smart city. In fact, we have already our test line that I have shown, and there is a plan to make the connection between the two extremes of this line, this island, with a maglev line. On one side, we have a lot of research centers from Schulenberg, FMC, General Electric, and many others, Siemens. And on the other side, we have a bus station. It would be nice to have this line inside the university campus. But something happened in my country that I do not know exactly how to explain. This is subject for a big discussion. But exactly when we started our prototype in 2014, the end of 2014, that was the on 1st of October 2014, was the last day of the Maglev conference, the inauguration of the Maglev COBRA, something happened in my country, like a bomb that exploded. The gross domestic product went down. And now, with COVID, I do not have big hopes. The same happened with the funds for science and technology. it was increasing until 2014, 2015, and like a bomb, it started to decrease. And the same happened with our project. We started in year 2000, until 2014, we were increasing. There were the contribution of many companies, banks, and funds. And it culminated with the conference and the start of operation of the vehicle. And now, with a, like a bomb, it started to decrease. It's a tragic coincidence that culminated with COVID. In fact, I have strategic partners, a company for transportation, another for linear motors, another that can make the production of rare earth magnets in Brazil, another company that can make the management in the market of the product. And I have also a lot of industrial partners all over the world. For instance, for the certification, we have contact in Germany, France, Italy. Also in Germany, the company ATZ makes the production of superconductors and cryostats, and we have a very close contact. But there are many other companies, some of them are the spin-off companies of our university. But there are also big ones like WEG that makes power electronics and motors in Valore. But the maglev squared cover can move again the industrial gears. For that, I need just $2.2 million. For what? To industrialize the vehicle, because it was a handmade vehicle, to improve the traction of the system, and to turn the vehicle autonomous, automated people mover. We want to make it autonomous. In fact, it's just we want to reach stage gates. Okay. What we can give in return for these $2.2 million, we can give the intellectual property rights. Part of the intellectual property will be given to someone who invests. I mean, really fight for these funds. It's incredible. People who knows me knows how I fight to raise these funds. And since 2015, it was not possible to find this investment. In conclusion, maglev trains are not just ordinary trains, but wings that will help mankind take another leap forward in the future. In fact, this first conclusion is not my conclusion. It's the conclusion of my colleagues from Korea, South Korea, from the Center for Urban Maglev Program. There is a second conclusion that the Maglev Squared Cobra is a sustainable project because we have ecological, economic, and social advantages. For instance, from the ecological point of view, our power consumption is lower, the audible noise emission is also low, and the impact in construction is really much smaller than all other technologies. From the economical point of view, it's cheaper to deploy than subway. It's practically the same cost of a light rail vehicle. And the operating and maintenance costs are lower. From the social reach, the project contributes to the quality of urban mobility and also favors the technological development. But in fact, to be at this level, level seven from NASA, I have to say thank you for a lot of colleagues of mine, many colleagues of mine. I have some names here. But when I see all these names, I know that they are just the tip of an iceberg. There are many other names that I do not have enough space here to write. And then, and this brings me to the third and most important conclusion of my presentation, that the challenge of technological development reveals hidden markets. A good way to overcome COVID's economic and social crisis. Maglev squared Cobra offers a promising return with a small investment, $2.2 million. I thank you for your attention. This is my email address. It's very easy to remember. Are the initial letters of my name, RMSUFAJ, is the Federal University of Rio de Janeiro, where I work, and BR is my country. This is the flag of Brazil, green, yellow, blue, and white. In these colors, you find always when you look to our sky. You find blue, white, green, and yellow. Also here, blue, white, green, and yellow. Everywhere you have blue, white, green, and yellow. I thank you for your attention, and I will be glad to answer, if possible, your questions. Thank you, German.